Hello everyone! Sorry for this long wait, I was quite busy recently. And without further ado, let's look at your entries, shall we? So, I will only discuss top 5, because, well, you remember how the last one went. It was too long, way too long, and like, doing top 10 out of 11 entries is... I don't know. But still, I will show all other entries that didn't make it to top 5 as honorable mentions, just so you guys can see all the stuff you sent me. I guess we should start... I wanna mention one thing. Remember how I said that you should make a soldier or a mercenary mock? Preferably not an alien guy. Normal size, preferably with a gas mask. Yes, you remember that, right? Cause... I'm just saying, like, cause half of the entries didn't seem to fit that criteria, but still, I don't get much, so I guess I can go with that. And besides, the best ones were kinda not, like... So, number 5, Lily from Wolf CS. So, that's a fairly simple mock, mostly built in CCBS style, which I don't really like because of how it was like completely overused and how it kinda killed the creativity in people's builds, but this one isn't a bad build because, well, because I had, as you may see in the future, builds that I liked less than this, but actually, no, this build wasn't that bad. It was nice, I would say, so nothing too great, but nothing like that makes my eyes hurt. Basically, it's a simple, small mock with like basic structure, basic armor, and I think body is maybe somewhat like interesting, but I actually can't see the body because of the coat. And yeah, coat is a nice detail. You people should use more clothing in your mocks because it may hide some bad places. But actually, I don't know, cloths are cool. And here the coat looks pretty well, cause it kinda makes the mock look more like a soldier and a mercenary, not just like a random whatever alien robot, I don't know, thing which many other people sent me. It's not like I'm pissed off, no, it's just like... Okay, maybe I'm a little pissed off. Never mind, so... And yeah, this mock actually has a weapon. It's a sniper rifle, as I can tell, probably, most likely. And it's... Well, you know I'm a gun guy, so you are probably won't be, like, too charitable about your weapons. But at least this guy tried something, and I like the way that he made the barrel with this light gray... pieces, which I don't see that often even being used at all in mocks. People still make weapons from Technic, like Technic guns. Are you in 2010? Come on, dude. Oh, okay, some more details about the mock. This head looks... This head looks nice, but it... I mean, that's a girl, I know that because... Because I saw the previous version of that mock and... Oh boy. I'm glad you remade this one, actually. The previous version was so bad. But... No, this head is actually quite nice. Two different colored ears. The only different colors in this mock except for, like, blue pins, but... So, again, to summarize. Very simple build. Nothing too complicated, nothing too like eye hurting. Maybe a bit too simple, I would say that, cause like legs are pure CCBS as well as arms kinda. But I like that this one is probably one of the most, is the closest to my contest theme, and it has that Mach has a weapon. Yeah, so I don't know. I'm actually like rambling because I don't have a script and I'm saying some shit. So thanks for your entry, and yeah, nice Mach. Thanks you for participating, and I'm going to the number 4. It's an unnamed Mach made by Yannick, and so this guy looks like, from the first glance, this guy looks too normal. Like, I actually don't know what to say about this guy. Everything is just like okay. So the color scheme is like, people put it colorless, so it's white, silver, gray, black colors. Basically, like, no matter how you change the hue of your system, it all of your, I mean, scheme, it always will remain this. And I don't really like those builds. It's hard to like tell a story, if you can say that, tell something about your Mach with just those colors. It's kind of boring. I mean, you can make some like, I don't know, metal guards or like gloomy, boring, again, guardians of something. But I don't know, this actually black and white color scheme may work sometimes, but if you add silver and gray, but I think gray bits aren't like necessary in here. It just makes everything look kinda like, it makes everything look like you didn't have any idea what to make in terms of colors and just like made someone. So about the weapons, usual Bionicle weapons, nothing to say. Oh, actually, the back of this Mach looks really bad, because mostly because of the colors. Yellow, gold, trans, clear, plus lime? Why? Those colors, I don't know. I don't see why those like trans, clear, lime pieces were used at all. They're, you can just take them away or use a different tube. But, huh, I'm saying too much shit about this Mach, it seems. Why I put it higher than the previous? Because, well, the build itself is quite neat. So, arms are, I don't really like them. It's almost as basic as pure CCBS bones. But I guess they can do. And, oh yeah, those shoulders, which are, I guess, the foreheads of those helmets, are too low for a shoulder. Just like, it looks weird, kinda. But anyway, legs look not bad. It's basically like a Toa build stuff with the legs. And at least some level of complication to them, which is admirable, shall I say. But yeah, actually kinda nothing too interesting about the legs. And also, I kinda think they are short, a bit, like, 1 point too short, maybe, if you compare them to the body and arms. Maybe 2. No, I think 1 point, I don't know. But the body, at least from the front, looks nice. It doesn't look like it can move or bend anywhere, and actually, spoiler, it can't. But yeah, it's still a... Back looks bad, like, redo something, remade it. Actually, back of the arms and legs as well looks not that good. So that that mock looks better from the front and worse from the back. And the head, it's a nice head. Yeah, I don't even know what to add. It's a pretty nice head. I don't know how this guy looks though. Where are the eyes? Where are the visor? What's the point of this helmet? How can you see through the like seamless texture? I don't know. Actually, don't judge me when I used this head, okay? Because I use this for an alien mock. I can do whatever with aliens. They are aliens, so. And lastly, this mock also corresponded to my contest theme quite well, so I can envision myself easily remaking this as a soldier mercenary guy. And props to you for that. And thanks for the entry. And I'm coming to the next one. Number 3. Death Note from Tornator. I'm sorry, I don't know how to pronounce this word. If you meant to spell like in Dreadnought, it's spelled differently, but oh, never mind. So, the third place, Dead Note from Tornator. So, this mock, I would say that I like this head. I really like it. In fact, I don't even know what are those pieces on sides. Those dark silver ones. They don't look like they're from Lego at all, actually. But I don't know. I guess I just never saw those. So this one actually looks like a gas mask. I would actually add that it looks like an exoskeleton. This whole build looks like an somewhat exoskeleton guy, except maybe for the feet, because they look like pieces of cannon. I don't know what people use those as boots, but I guess. And so this guy maybe looks a little bit too complicated, like in a sense that it's messy. So this whole build is messy in terms of colors and layering of pieces. So in terms of colors, you have black, gray, dark red, dark silver, usual silver, usual red, and for some reason those two trans cyan pieces, also blue pins, but I guess that's not a big deal concerning how many of kind of the same colors you have at the same time on your mocks. So basically, when you have dark red and red, that's not a very good combo. Like, if you look at his arms, it doesn't blend well at all. Usually those two colors don't go well together. I don't know. Only except for like clothing special like details, like I don't know, flesh, blood, torture, death, I don't know. Silver bits would look for, I guess the main problem is that gray doesn't look that fitting. Dark silver also may be replaced, and it's all over everywhere. I don't know, this mock has too many pieces in different colors near each other, and my main problem is that it's, again, as I said, messy. But it's still a pretty nice mock, I would say, and actually this one looks the best in terms of fitting in my universe, because it looks, this guy looks like a human in every sense except for the legs, which are actually too short. I think like 2 or 3 points if we measure it with like the body and arm length. Actually, those arms are kind of a bit longer than for a usual human, because I guess those are gloves or like gauntlets. And yeah, looking at this guy, I actually don't think he can bend his legs. I don't know, that seems like a problem. It's like two giant pillars instead of actually functional legs, but I don't know. Too bad this guy doesn't have any weapons, but too good it has a gas mask. Something looking like a gas mask. Even if there's no tube, I can like, I believe that this one is a working helmet. I really like this mask. I don't know what to add, except for thanks for the entry, and you made it to top three. Congratulations. So for the next two entries, I kinda struggled who would gonna be the second and the first one, because both of them were roughly in the same level of skill and quality as the other. It was really hard to choose from those two. Every one of those had some upsides and downsides, and I don't know, maybe you can disagree with me in the comments, I don't know, but still, I will explain everything I think about those two and compare their upsides and downsides, as I mentioned. So, never mind, what the fuck am I saying? Am I inventing language now, even though I can't really speak it properly? Oh, okay. So, never mind. Number two, Miles Treft by meep199. So, that's a guy with some backstory that I won't explain to you, because it, like all other backstories from even the characters I won't include, would be in the description of this video. So, yeah, give it a read, people. Sometimes people not just make mocks, they make stories for their mocks, so people can enjoy more and understand the struggles their characters went through. And I appreciate that. It kind of sounded like I was making fun, but no, I actually appreciate that, like, seriously. So, this guy, I like his color scheme, even though it has some questionable moments, but in general, I like the trans green plus brown plus like dark colors presented in this mug. And basically, I don't know what's like under the coat, so I would just like imagine there's something super basic, and I don't care, cause that coat looks quite good, and it, as far as I can tell, you made it yourself. It looks custom, which is cool. So I'll, I guess, say the main detail everyone probably noticed is those arms, which are something I never seen before. I kinda don't see people using those like trans clear radioactive trash cans used in their mugs, but they look exactly like they would. They look exactly like you would imagine arms need to look on a guy that shoots acid from his arms. So this idea delivered perfectly. I don't even know what to add. Those arms are good, interesting, and creative. Now for the legs, which aren't kinda any of those I'm set for the arms. It's a basic CCBS, really thin, really unthick ass piece and thighs, and lower one is better. It looks quite well, but also kinda like too rectangly. I don't know. If you look from the side, this legs looks not that interesting, but not bad. I'm just comparing to the arms, and because I know you can do better. And those white leg pieces, I'm not sure what are they representing, but I won't actually whine or complain how they're completely not from the color scheme. They kind of look fitting. Silver boots, on the other hand, why? Like, this guy uses dark silver and everything, but oh, actually, it has a silver helmet. Never mind. Moving on. So this guy has a gas mask, even though I'm not really seeing where the tube is coming from, but at least thank you for your appreciation of my rules, because that would make sense for this guy, him being like the toxic acid spitter person. I also really like this, not the scarf, this like tube on his neck. I don't know how to name this place, but it's a great usage of this part, which I even forgot existed. And body looks interesting as well, even though I can't see most of it. I assume it's a nice one. Oh, what can I say? Yeah, that's a pretty good mug. The only downside, huge downside, is that he's not really like... I can't imagine him in either of my universes. Not in my new lore, which I specifically mentioned I would make a mug in my own version. And my own version of your mug would be featured in my new lore, not in my current lore. But even the current lore, this guy wouldn't, like, make sense, because it's not that fantastical. It's sci-fi, but not, like, super hard, super, like, weird and random alien tech sci-fi. But yes, the main problem is I have with this guy, apart from the legs, is that he just doesn't seem fitting in the whole universe, but... It's a very nice mug from a very nice mug maker. Damn, my vocabulary is really weak. Nice, cool. Why am I using those words? Are there any other words, like, I can use? I don't know. My language is bad. So, thanks for your entry. Thanks for participating. And... I'm coming to the first one, but before that, let's see some honorable mentions. First place, Blackwater by H.S. Rocco Diora. So, I always liked this guy's mocks for the color schemes, for the custom torsos, which he makes, unlike most of the people, including me, and for the fact that he has lores written for many of his characters. And if I will discuss this mock, I will point out that it doesn't look at all like it will be compatible with my universe. It's not a human-like. It looks like a mercenary, I guess, but it's one of the most alien ones I received. But still, surprisingly, the color scheme, the face, the weapon, it makes sense, even though those tubes from the head go somewhere in his spine or ass. I'm not sure how does this system work, but I guess aesthetically it's right. And the head is actually quite interesting. So it has some silver hairs. This I don't know how this thing is called, with like deep water fishes have this thing on there. Like I can't even explain, holy shit. This small tail on the top of his head, I mean, that's a cool addition. Whole this build reminds of something fishy. I may even say that there's something fishy about this guy, you know? I'm sorry. Okay, I'm gonna continue. If I just talk about this build, so I would say that arms and legs are like the same in good places and same in bad respects as well. The bad thing with those legs and arms is that they're too straight, so they're like rectangular all the way up, from top to bottom, from up to down, from high to low. I don't know, use whatever which one you prefer. And what I mean is that they don't go beyond more than, I think, 2 or 3 points in the side, and they stay the same like all the way. For arms it's actually 2 points, for legs it's at least 2, maybe a bit more. And I don't really like that. I like curvature, and arms and legs here kinda lack this aspect. But at the same time, they're quite complicated, not complicated, quite detailed, not too simple, not like too detailed, something in between, something I like, something everyone should like, to be honest. Okay, or not, like whatever you want. I'm sorry for imposing my views on you. And the color scheme is actually, maybe it could have been better if you'd add more lime, because again, like I said couple mocks before, when you make a guy with silver, gray and black as the only colors, it's boring. But here this guy has occasional lime. It just, this lime is almost never seen. Only the tail and knees have this. And yeah, there's also a trans neon green color, yes, which is, to be fair, a different color, and those tubes are also a different color. And I don't know, maybe actually all this works together, because it's a little bit of each limey part in this guy, which is nice. This is how you can make a colorless build interesting just by adding one single color over black, gray, silver, white, etc. Also, it's a pretty neat helmet, which kind of reminds a gas mask and a visor, and also it has, like, as I mentioned before, silver hair coming from the back and this fishtail flashlight thing on the top. So yeah, I chose this one as the first one because this build it feels complete. It's like it doesn't look like it has many gaps or it lacks something. For instance, I don't know what to add here, except maybe for lime bits, but I don't even think it's necessary, actually. This one is what you guys need to remember. Make your mocks look finished, like, everything should be like... how do I explain that? Everything fits, everything, like, flows. Everything works. And curvature, actually. This one lacks curvature, but yeah. I guess I can go with that. And oh, actually, this guy also has some weapons. Those elect claws. I saw them today before somewhere. And this simple, I guess, pistol? I don't know, maybe it's a short shotgun, I don't know, but I appreciate you making a weapon, as I really like people following my rules, even though they weren't followed in all aspects, but I mean, it's not like it's up for me to ask, it's not like I'm that popular, so again, it looks like I'm whining. I'm not. I'm just ranting. Thanks for the entry. You won. So, take your prize. And I mean, wait till I make your mug in my universe. Not a mug. A mug of your mug. Which actually, with this mug... it's gonna be quite hard to make a human one in a way that it would resemble your mug. I actually don't think it's possible, even though I can try, I guess. Maybe you... I can view it as though you gave me some an advice to how make a color scheme. I don't know. You can guess how hard can it be to turn this guy into a human from my universe, but again, I made those rules, I should suffer for them, not you. Thanks for the entry, thank you all guys for watching and for entering. Again, sorry for the wait, and I'll see you soon, maybe sometime, even though I kinda like don't YouTube recently. Never mind.